When it comes to fiberglass, there's a thousand different ways to do it, and a lot of people have different theories on the best way to do it. I'm going to show you a way that I've done fiberglass in the past, and I think it's a very easy way, and it's pretty forgiving if you do it this way. Originally, I said I was going to put down fiberglass tape first. I changed my mind. I'm going to do the sheet, the big sheet of fiberglass, and then I'm going to use the tape if the edges look messed up. That way, it'll be a little bit more like trim, and it'll look really, really good. I'm using spray adhesive, and I know some people are not going to agree with this. The reason I do this is because it gives you the ability to put down the fiberglass exactly where you want. So I'm only using a tiny bit because I don't want any of this to really mess with the cure of my fiberglass or do anything weird underneath the fiberglass. I just need a tiny bit to hold the fiberglass in place so it looks good and it makes it easy when I go over it with epoxy. So I think you can see the reason I do it this way. It gives you the ability to really control where the fiberglass is laid and how it's laid down before you start throwing an epoxy on top of it. So as you can see, fiberglass cloth is pretty manageable if you just take your time and if you use this spray adhesion method to be able to lay down the glass. I also put it down in sections, so I don't ever try to do folds with large pieces of fiberglass because you'll just get wrinkles in these creases and they're a giant pain. So what I end up doing is I overlay the two pieces, I cut them, and then I'll use my tape on top of them. So I use 2-inch tape to cover up the seam and it'll look really good. So the key to fiberglass is to take your time and do it in small sections. Do not try to pour fiberglass over your entire boat in one shot. So just taking my time, I'm gonna work this one little front section and then I'll move on to another section. So last night I put down my first layer of fiberglass and now I'm just going back and I'm sanding the high spots. This is the point inside your project that can take either a few hours or it can take a few days. It depends on what level of detail you're trying to go for. When dealing with fiberglass, the steps in between, how much you sand and how much attention to detail you pay really makes huge dividends for the look of your finished product. But at the same time, this is going to be a utility boat for me, so I'm not too worried as long as it looks pretty good. So right now, everything does look really good. This first layer went down, and this is what happens when you lay fiberglass at night and you can't see very well. So I could have saved myself a little bit of time if I could see what I was doing, and I would have pulled a lot of this goo all the way off as opposed to having to just sand through it now. So it looks really good right now, and what I'm planning on doing is we're just gonna sand it down, then we're gonna tape the seams, and we should be good. We'll be right back. epoxy on the top side now, and what I'm going to do next is I'm going to seal my flotation boxes. In this design, some people put like a little hatch or something right here and then use it as storage, plus they can inspect it, and as long as it stays watertight, it will remain good for flotation. I don't want to worry about it at all. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to epoxy the inside, seal it up, and then I'm going to fill it with boat foam. So that way I know this boat will be absolutely bomb-proof. Even if it completely turns upside down, it will still float because of the boat foam. So I'm a big whitewater boater, and I'm a huge fan of flotation. I know how important it is, and it can really keep you out of a bind. So that's what I'm planning on doing next. Boat foam is super cool, but it can be a handful. It's really simple stuff. You just gotta work pretty fast. Part A, part B, one-to-one, mixed up as good as you can, and then you lay it down in layers. You don't try to do too much of the stuff at once. You'll just make a giant mess. You a quick trick. Boat foam is pretty expensive. I mean, it's not crazy expensive, but it's different. First of all, you can only use boat foam. You can't use expanding foam like construction foam, because that stuff doesn't have closed bubbles. It tends to turn into a giant sponge as opposed to a giant piece of flotation like styrofoam. So that's why you have to use the boat kind of expanding foam. But second of all, I'm going to show you how to save a few bucks, and I'm going to take some random styrofoam that I have from, you know, stuff, and I'm gonna break it up, and I'm gonna take up some of the volume, but I'm gonna encapsulate it inside my expanding foam. So I don't want it to be on the edge, I want it to be in the middle. But this will save you a few bucks, and it'll help your foam go a little bit further. I just got done cutting out the skegs for the bottom of my boat, and I'm not gonna lie to you, this feels like cheating. I am now using a MakerMade M2, which I paid full retail for because I was excited about this piece of gear, and I was also skeptical, so I didn't want to do a review or anything and then be super disappointed. So I went ahead and paid retail for it. And I gotta tell you, it was a little scary at first, getting it set up. But after that, unbelievable. Yes, I'm gonna do a video about it, but honestly, it feels like cheating. This is definitely a game changer when it comes to making stuff. So we'll talk about it a little bit later. Got my skegs cut out. Let's go install those. And we're almost done with this phase two of this project. Whew. I am done with fiberglass, and it couldn't have happened any sooner. I was ready to be done with fiberglass. As you can see, fiberglass can be a little intimidating, and it can certainly be challenging. But I will tell you, I learned a lot during this process of this type of building boats. I told you I'd built boats a long time ago, but a different process. But I gotta tell you, I got about halfway through this, and I picked up this book right here. Man, I wish I had read it before I started this. It's called Epoxy Basics by Russell Brown, and it's awesome. I'll put a link in the description, but man, I learned a lot just from this book, and it taught me mostly of why some of my mistakes tended to get really kind of bad. More specifically, these tapes were
garbage. I didn't like using them. And one of the things I learned by reading a book was that you can make your own tapes just from cutting it out of the fiberglass cloth. I also probably wouldn't have done the bottom in different sections. I probably would have done it in one sheet. Now that I know a little bit better on how to fold over fiberglass and get it to fit and everything, but tons of lessons learned, and this is going to be a utility boat. I don't want to spend just a ton of time on the bottom of the boat because you're not going to see it anyway. I'm ready to go to the next stage. We're going to do some paint. We're going to do some outfitting. It's going to be awesome, and I'm going to use my new machine, my M2 from MakerMade, and that is an amazing piece of gear, and I can't wait to show you that. So stay tuned. I appreciate you guys hanging out there with me, and if you got any questions, you know where to check us out, commandedesigns.com. I'm Tony D. We'll be right back.